Vibra danio, info and care. Among many other aquarium fish, the zebra danio has to be a favorite for many people. The reason for their popularity and appeal is their behavior. And if you're a beginner just starting on your aquarium hobby, then this is a fish you must have in your aquarium for sure. Now, if you don't know anything about the zebra danio, I'm here to help you. I will give you all the information you need about zebra danio to provide them with the proper care and have them in your aquarium. Welcome to our channel. In today's video, we will be taking a look at the zebra danio, but before I begin, be sure to hit that like button. It lets me know that you're enjoying videos like this. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click that notification bell. And without further ado, let's get right into it. Taking care of the zebra danio. When you get a fish for your aquarium, you have to research and know many things about them. Here I'll go through something like natural habitat, diet, breeding, behavior, and so on about zebra danio. So let's get started right away. Natural habitat. You can find a zebra danio living in several kinds of conditions. It can live in rivers that flow at a slow pace. This is primarily the case in the dry seasons, and during the monsoon, you may see them in flooded pools or maybe in rice paddies filled with water. Usually, they will live in places where they can receive daylight for 12 or more hours. Places with these characteristics are natural habitats for these fish. Physical description. Zebra danio fish are pretty small in size. They can have a length of up to 2 inches with proper growth. Typically, the fish's body is either silver or gold with some blue stripes going across the body. An excellent way to identify male and female zebra danio is through their colors. The male fish has a more golden color, whereas the female ones tend to have a silver color. Other than these natural ones, you may come across different kinds of zebra danio from breeders. Ideal tank setup. The tank setup for zebra danio is pretty straightforward. You have to start with sediment, where you can use sand as the sediment. After laying the substrate, you can move on to adding water. I will discuss the water parameters in a bit. For the plants, you can use Java fern or you can go with Amazon sword plants. You can also go for both if you want. Doing this gives the water dissolved oxygen in high concentrations. As for the size of the tank, you don't need to worry too much. Since zebra danios are quite small in size, a small to moderately sized tank is enough for them. You can fit 3 to 5 zebra danios in a 10-gallon tank. A good filtration system is needed to keep the bio and chemical balance in check. Also, you'll need an artificial light source setup. You have to ensure it lights up the aquarium for at least 12 hours a day to recreate the daylight of the natural habitats of the zebra danio. Water parameters. Now, water parameters are crucial to maintaining the health and growth of your fish. For zebra danio, their preferable water temperature is around 65 to 78 degrees Fahrenheit. As for pH levels, you should keep them between 6 to 8. And make sure to add water right after laying the substrate. Also, do it slowly. Diet. When a zebra danio is in the wild, they feast on worms, algae, mosquito larvae, and small crustaceans. However, in an aquarium, you can feed them a lot of different types of food. To make sure their diet is balanced, you can keep quality flake as the core food. Along with that, you can try out different kinds of vegetables, like spinach, zucchini, shelled peas, etc. As for living food, bloodworms and daphnia are always viable. You can feed them pinch-sized amounts several times a day to meet their daily nutrition. Behavior and tank mates. The reason the zebra danio is quite popular is due to their behavior. They're very calm and social in characteristics, making them a great companion for other species in your tank. Several other fish go well with zebra danio in the same tank. You can go with scarlet baddies or emerald puffer fish. Then there are options like rosy barbs, bronze corys, rummy nose tetras, the popular neon tetra, and the bristle nose pleco. You can also mix them up with African dwarf frogs or zebra snails and even freshwater shrimp. Although you should avoid any predatory type of fish, such as different species of catfish. Breeding. As a beginner, this is a perfect fish for you to start breeding on. You can begin by separating the male and female for a few weeks and then create a temperature of around 70 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit. You can feed the high-quality food during that time, and you'll notice a change in the female fish. Then, after 2 weeks, put the male and female fish in the same breeding tank. Remember, for a single female fish, you have to put 2 male fish in the tank. Once you see the spawning, you can get the fish back into their regular home tank. Otherwise, they may start eating their eggs. If the eggs are fertile, then they will take 3 days to hatch. Diseases. Unfortunately, zebra danios are prone to suffering from all kinds of ailments with freshwater fish. Issues like ick, fungal infections, parasitic infections, and so forth. Aside from those common ones, there's also a disease called mycobacteriosis. When this happens, your fish will suffer from inflammation, ulcers, and loss of fin. And the bad news, it's not easy to treat either. If you notice these symptoms, your first course should be to remove the infected fish and change the water. To sum it up, all in all, it's not that difficult to take care of zebra danio, which makes them an excellent fish for beginners. You don't have to put a lot of effort or time to ensure they get a good quality of life. Also, it's pretty easy to have them in your aquarium with all the other fish due to their behavior characteristics. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit the like button and leave a comment. And I'll see you in the next video.